In a previous video, we talked about the matrix of a linear transformation when the input space and the output space were both Rn or R Euclidean spaces, a map from Rn to Rm. Now we're going to do it for a general vector space. So the idea is our inputs are going to be in some vector space V, and it's an n-dimensional vector space. It's got a basis B, which is B1, B2, B3, Bn. And then our output space is going to be a vector space, an m-dimensional vector space, and it has a basis d1 through dm. And we have some linear transformation that takes a vector in V and spits out a vector in W. And we want to make sense of that. We want to understand that in terms of matrices. And it boils down to this picture. See, V looks like Rn, because every vector here, we can take its coordinates using the B basis and get a vector in Rn. And W looks like Rm. So L should kind of look like a linear transformation from Rn to Rm. We've already seen that every linear transformation from Rn to Rm is given by an m by n matrix. So ideally, we'd like to find a matrix, which we're going to write LdB, that takes the coordinates of the input and spits out the coordinates of the output. In other words, just that. It converts the coordinates of the input to the coordinates of the output and so you take the coordinates of the input, that's the coordinates in the B basis, you multiply by this matrix, and you get the coordinates of the output. And of course, the output is in W, so these coordinates are in the D basis. Okay. Well, here's the formula. Here's the answer. This matrix that converts inputs in B to outputs in D, you get it by applying L to B1, B2, Bn, and then taking the coordinates of those in the D basis. Now, if you remember, when we had something going from Rn to Rm, we got the matrix by applying L to the first basis vector, E1, up through L to the En, and we didn't bother taking coordinates because it was already in Euclidean space. Now we have to use the basis vectors B1 through Bn instead of E1 through En, and we have to take coordinates, but it's really the same formula. So let's work an example. In our example, our input space is going to be the space of cubic polynomials. So our input might be something like 1 plus 2t minus 3t squared plus 4t cubed. And our output space is going to be the space of quadratic polynomials. And there's an obvious basis for each of these spaces. The basis for cubic polynomials is 1t t squared t cubed. The basis for quadratics is 1t and t squared. And our operator is going to be the derivative. So you give me a cubic polynomial, I'll take its derivative, and that's a quadratic polynomial. And we want to express that as a matrix. So what we have to do is we have to take L of B1, L of B2, L of B3, L of B4. This is, so B1 is 1, B2 is t, B3 is t squared, B4 is t cubed. We have to take L of those. That means taking derivatives. What's the derivative of 1? 0. What's the derivative of t? 1. What's the derivative of t squared? 2t. What's the derivative of t cubed? 3t squared. And then we have to take the coordinates of these guys in the d basis. The coordinates of 0 in the d basis are just 0, 0, 0. 0 is 0 times 1 plus 0 times t times 0 times t squared. The coordinates of 1 is 1 times 1 plus 0 times t plus 0 times t squared. 2t is 0 times 1 plus 2 times t plus 0 times t squared. And 3t squared is 0 times 1 plus 0 times t plus 3 times t squared. So there we have it. There is the matrix that computes the derivative. If you write down the coefficients of a cubic polynomial and multiply that by this matrix, you get the coefficient of its derivative. And it's a 3x4 matrix because there are 4 coefficients for the input, because it's cubic. There are only 3 coefficients for the output, because it's just quadratic. So why does it work? Well, every vector can be decomposed in a basis. So you give me an arbitrary vector in the input space, and I can write that as something times b1 plus something times b2 plus something times bn. And those somethings, I'll call them x1 through xn. In other words, the coordinates of v in the b basis are x1 through xn. And then we just apply L to this. L to a linear combination, it's linear. So it's L times this piece plus L times this piece plus L times this piece, and L times this piece is x1 times L of b1. Okay. So there's L of v, and now we take coordinates of everything in sight. The coordinates of L of v is x1 times the coordinates of b1, L of b1 plus xn times the coordinates of L of bn, and all the terms in between. So we get a linear combination of this, L of b1 in the d coordinates, L of b2 in the d coordinates, L of bn in the d coordinates, with coefficients x1 through xn. But that's what matrix multiplication is. That's what you get when you take the product of this matrix with this vector. You get x1 times the first column plus x2 times the second column plus xn times the last column. So lo and behold, this was our formula for the matrix of the linear transformation, and this is the coordinates of v in the b basis. There we go. It works. Hey, last point is that sometimes the input space and the output space are the same thing. In our example, we said derivative of a cubic is a quadratic. But we could have worked with, say, the space of, the space of 2x2 matrices, and our operation was a transpose. There are lots of operations where the input and the output spaces are the same. And if the input and the output spaces are the same, then we call it an operator. An operator is a linear transformation from a vector space to itself. And if the input and output spaces are the same, then it's pretty natural to take the basis for the output space to be the same as the basis for the input space. You don't have to, but it's usually a good idea. And so if you just use one basis, it's kind of silly to write two subscripts saying input basis is B and output basis is B. Since you're just using the basis B, you just write L sub B. So in other words, you only have one space, you only have one basis, and you say the coordinates of the output in the B basis is the matrix of L with respect to B times the matrix of V with times the coordinates of V with respect to B. But you should remember that these are kind of different objects. These are the coordinates of a vector. This is the matrix of the linear transformation. This really has two indices, B and B, and we're just writing one of them because we're lazy.